All right, so in this video, what we're going to do is go over a type of hypothesis test of correlation and use the six-step procedure from the Nolan and Heinzen Statistics for the Behavioral Sciences. This is for Dr. B's Psych 200 Statistics course. All right, so for a silly example, what we did was we took some data from Missouri where we looked at the number of churches in a town and the number of bars in a town to see if they were related. We fudged the data just a little bit to make it work, but mostly this is real data. And so I want to know if there are more churches in a town, are there more bars, and vice versa. So this is correlation, so I'm not predicting that one causes the other. All right, so given that following data, is the correlation significant at 0.05? And that's what we're going to use for our criterion on this test. So if you want to enter this data yourself, remember that each person gets their own row. So in this case, it's each city gets its own row. So we've got our two big cities here, St. Louis, Kansas City, and then some of our other smaller cities. And we're looking at if bars and churches are related to each other. So each city gets a score for bars and a score for churches. So first thing I did was create a scatter plot in SPSS, as it always helps to see the data. And you'll notice that we've got the two big outliers, and those are our two big cities, and then a bunch of little ones down here. But in general, the pattern of the data is positive, right? So there appears to be a positive relationship where there are more bars or more churches. But what would really help is if we add the line of best fit. That's traditionally reserved for regression, but that'll help you see one of the assumptions, and it'll kind of give you a good feel for what direction the correlation should be. So we already know that R should be positive. And the dots are fairly close to the line. This is probably the farthest one away. So R is probably going to be a pretty large number too. Okay. So the first step is assumptions. So I want to look at, are the IV and the DV both scale variables? Okay. I guess they both could be zero, although it's not likely. So I would say yes, they're ratio scales. The next question is, are they both normal? Well, I don't have at least 30 people, so I can't assume normality. So I'm going to say no, because I'm not sure. The third one is random selection. And since I could Google each and every city in our state or the US, I suppose, and that sort of data is available online, I could say yes, I could randomly select cities across the US. I didn't, but I could have. And then the last one is homoscedasticity. Okay. So what you want to do is look at your scatter plot and make sure the spread of the variables is the same, roughly the same across the distribution of the data. And I'd say it's kind of iffy because here they're pretty close, and here they're kind of far away. But I only have a couple of points. So I would probably say yes, that one point needs some friends so we can check it better. But the spread appears to be the same all the way down the rest of the data. For the second step, we're going to list the two variables we're using. So we got bars and churches. For the research hypothesis, basically we're going to say that the correlation is not zero between the two. So R is not zero. Remember that we assume that rho is zero. And for the null hypothesis, we're going to say that R is zero. So this is basically testing if a correlation exists at all, and we're not predicting a direction. Step three is pretty easy. So I ran this in SPSS. I have a separate video if you want to remember how to calculate this in SPSS. So here's R. So SPSS assumes that you're dumb, and it gives it to you twice. So this is the same thing both directions, and then it tells you the correlation with itself. So you really only have to look at half of the box. Make sure it's the one where it says Pearson correlation. So you would say R is 0.904. So that's huge. Remember that things close to one are very large. Things close to zero are small. For step four, what I need is n, which was 7. So that gives me 5 degrees of freedom. Remember, it's n minus 2, 1 for x and 1 for y. And we said 0.05, and we're going to use a two-tailed test because we did equal to and not equal to. So it's plus and minus 2.571. Because it's a two-tailed test, it can be positive or negative. All right, so step five is the evil step. So the calculation for t, when we're looking at r, gets kind of tricky. So first thing I'm going to do is fill everything in. Then I'm going to show you the faster way to do it. So I filled in r. So if we calculate the bottom out, that's 904 divided by the square root of 0.183. That's a 3. Try that again. Divided by 5, which equals 0.904 divided by 0.191. Gracious. So that gives me 4.73. Now if r is positive, t is positive. So make sure you don't lose a negative here at the front. Or what you can do is put this in a moat. You need to enter the correlation coefficient and n, and it will auto-calculate the t statistic for you. So this is kind of a cheat because this page is Cohen's d to r, and it calculates Cohen's d for you from r, but that's not what we're using it for. We're using it to not make any math mistakes, and it will actually calculate t right here for you. So that's one quicker way to do it, but this is the formula. So r divided by the square root of 1 minus r squared, which is the effect size, 1 minus the effect size, divided by degrees of freedom on the bottom here. So remember, this is df. So we get the same answer, 4.73. So in step 6, I want to know if 2.571, which is my cutoff for critical score, is further out than my other score. So fail here, reject out here. And our score was 4.73. So we would reject the null. The number of churches and bars are related in a positive fashion. So as you get more churches, you get more bars. Or it could be the other way. As you get more bars, you get more churches. Or it could be related to another variable such as population density. So just as you have more people, you have more churches and more bars, which is probably the most likely of the combinations. And so remember, the correlation has many interpretations. So it's a fantastic statistic, but can sometimes be difficult because it has so many limitations with outliers, restriction of range, causality, I don't know which way it goes, and the third variable problem. So all of that taken together is the 6 steps for hypothesis testing for determining if the correlation coefficient is significant.